Good morning and welcome to Word on the Street Wednesdays.
Well, it used to be called that.
Your host, Meg O'Shaughnessy.
And I'm your other host, Dave Barabbas.
Woohoo! We're excited to be here, if you can't tell, because we've got a word for you.
Yeah, we've got a word.
There are some things out there that you need to know about.
Maybe even more than one word.
And we are happy to tell you about it.
Yes, we are so happy. Dave. Our first word is chores.
I love that word, Dave.
Since a viral video went out on Monday, some amazing things have been happening in our county.
It's amazing.
Tell us about it,
right, Meg. Down the street in Western Paulsbo, a 17-year-old girl did the dishes for her mother for the first time. That's right. It's pretty amazing. And we've got some real footage of that right here, right now, that we cannot wait to show you.
Let's cut to that footage.
Let's go over there.
I do declare, my sweetie pie, I found her doing the dishes and it made me the happiest thing ever. Whenever she's bored, she tries to bathe the cat that we have. But not today. No, no, no. I came out to the kitchen yelling like, "Oh, little sweetie, are you washing that cat again? He doesn't like water." But then I looked over and all of the dishes were done.
It blew this mother's mind so much she couldn't contain it. A mother's love for the child.
I'm still proud. She is such a little peach, and I just am so proud of her. She's growing up, you know. This virus is really doing it for some people.
Handle business, not a joke. Yeah, manners missing. Travel different, no control. Yeah, time to listen.
This video has encouraged people all over the county. People are sweeping the floors, vacuuming, sweeping, serving. I heard a story in particular of one girl who made a cheesecake for her dad's birthday.
Oh my goodness.
Can you believe that?
That's amazing.
Sweetest thing I've ever heard.
Wow.
As a lot of you know, in the world right now, we are going through something I'd like to call a toilet paper shortage. Kind of a funny little thing, really.
Some people have toilet paper.
Some people don't. And it's kind
of
not great. But there's been some groundbreaking news. Why don't you tell us about it, Dave?
We received a video just earlier today from a young man in Bremerton who managed to figure out how to make toilet paper out of cauliflower.
You can make anything out of cauliflower.
Absolutely anything.
Am I right?
You're right.
I mean, it's amazing what
they
you
say
can
that
do
online.
So we just got this footage and we are so excited to share it with you.
So let's cut to that footage now.
Take us away, Bill.
Goes over there.
Greetings! Welcome to my laboratory. I'm a local inventor here in Bremerton, and my name is Sparley Chancel. And as you've heard, I've devised a scientific method to turn the lowly cauliflower into usable bathroom tissue for common purposes around a household. So if you'll join me, I'll show you my delicate and highly chemistry-laden method for that transformation. Now, it's important for you to take exact notes because it's a very detailed and thorough method. Please get out a notepad so you can take good, careful notes. Now, as you can see here, I've got some of the ingredients for this cauliflower toilet paper project. I'm going to prepare my workspace here by creating a lubricating film on top of the heating element. We're removing some of the excess organic matter from the cauliflower. Now, as you can see, I've begun chopping the cauliflower into pieces no larger than 17 grams or roughly 4.5 centimeters by any dimension. I'm introducing some acids to the chemical reaction to break down the complex and basic nature of the cauliflower, crushing some black pepper over the top. Next, we're using a highly iodized version of sea salt, again, to break down the basic structure. And we're adding just a touch of garlic into the mixture. I'm placing the completed heating element with the cauliflower, soon to be bathroom tissue, into the oven, which has been preheated to 325 degrees. We've leave it in there for roughly 30 to 40 minutes. Toilet paper.
And our last word for you today is...
community. We all need community.
Yeah, we do.
And one youth group in Bremerton has decided to reach out to make community happen on an app called
Zoom.
This is incredible news.
I love it.
We want to encourage you, if you're a high schooler or middle schooler, to join that youth group on Zoom tonight. For now, give us some encouragement down below in the comments
Tell us your words.
PBF Youth.
All the great things. Tagging makes us feel special.
Thank you for joining us for Word Wednesday.
As many of you have are Word Win. If you want to be a part of a really encouraging group of people who are a community of people,
we've got some encouraging news for you this morning. Word.
That was back when there was actually things to talk about on the street. So
we've heard a few things
this week,
but not on the street. The streets aren't very busy today. Since a viral video was released on Monday, every day's a Wednesday.
All right.
Excellent.
Back to the news. That's what actually matters.
That's right.
Okay.
We're the weirdest neighbors.
Oh, there's more people.
People are supposed to be at home.
I know.
Come on.